With us now is filmmaker Lawrence. He goes by Law Watford. Welcome to the show. How are you?
Very good to be here.
Good. How'd you get that nickname, Law?
Those are actually my initials.
Okay.
So I grew up, actually, since elementary school, everybody would say Law, and I was like, okay.
Ah.
So now nobody knows Lawrence. If you ask who Lawrence is on a film set, nobody knows.
Right.
Say, oh, Law.
Law. Got it. Where did you grow up?
Brooklyn, New York. Until junior year in high school, moved to Virginia, and then I went to graduate school and undergrad in Virginia. Now I'm back in New York.
Why did you come back to New York? Because of the whole film vibe was calling to you?
Yeah, well, actually, I follow my wife. She's a Georgian girl, a Georgia girl, Peach, and met in Virginia. And then she said, hey, I'm going back to New York, which is where she, you know, was in print media. And I said, I'll follow you. I was determined to be the Tyler Perry of Virginia, but wasn't as many opportunities there, so I'm back.
And speaking of Tyler Perry, I know that he's giving a big speech about that coming up in January.
Okay.
So great. You're a big fan of his work?
I am. You're a big fan of his work.
So here you are in New York, and you did your own project called Flipped.
Yes.
You directed it.
Yeah, I'm the director. It was the brainchild of a friend of mine from undergrad named Jack Manning III. He went to Hampton University along with me, and he had this idea to do a film that kind of address racial injustices, but in a flip reverse way to kind of see if there was a way to artistically create a sense of empathy. So he brought on a screenwriter friend of ours, also from Hampton, named Tiffany Burgess. And she penned the script, and we did whatever we had to do to whip up the money, go in our pockets, beg, borrow, but we were able to get it done. And it's been, you know, pretty impactful.
And what is that? What is the message you want the viewer to get from this film?
I mean, I think the main message is the reason that we face so many injustices in this country and we deal with those issues is that people just lack empathy. And it's very difficult to see yourself outside of yourself, especially when in this bubble environment that we're in, whether it's on social media, Facebook, Instagram. So this is a film that it challenges the viewer to identify with somebody outside of themselves. And it actually, it goes both ways. So while it's challenging, you know, white folks to understand maybe what it's like to be in a position of a black person, it's also challenging black folks to understand what it's like to be in a position of white people in certain situations, particularly police. So it's an issue that kind of is like a little charged, but that's where we need to go to kind of heal, in a sense.
I agree. Just people talking about it.
Yeah.
You know, and from all different angles and having an understanding. And like you said, having some empathy.
Yes.
You know, because we're all human.
Yeah.
You know, at the end of the day, I'm a human. You're a human. We both want the same thing. We want love.
Right.
We want people to care, that we care about, to do well in life. We want everyone to succeed.
Right.
And I think it's more that type of connection that I think people are really, they're in so much need of right now. I think if people could come on some kind of common ground,
absolutely.
Some humanity, some kindness.
That's the word.
It's going to make a whole difference in the world.
Right.
So you did Flipped.
Yeah.
And you do some writing. You also do some directing. You said you'd like to have an agent.
Yeah. That's always the big prize.
Okay.
So I'm working on getting an agent. Actually just came back from the Merge Summit in Los Angeles this weekend. You know, as you work on that, you continue to build your own brand and build your own products. So, and I guess my beeline has been kind of social issues, you know, whether it's through drama, whether it's through comedy, just writing stories and creating projects. So the next project actually deals with school shootings.
Oh.
So a friend, Brandon Fobbs out in LA, decided to kind of create this project that talks about, again, empathy and a lack of empathy that kind of informs and makes people feel isolated and leads to things like violence in schools and that kind of, you know, things of that nature, so.
Well, while you're here, I know that you brought a clip from Flipped.
Yes.
So let's take a look.
All right, can you model this situation you're telling me about? Because, you know, you and these relationships, I ain't
really have information on the individual.
Look at this one, Kai.
We are confronted primarily with a moral issue. The heart of the question is whether all Americans are to be afforded equal rights and equal opportunities. If an American, because his skin is white, cannot eat lunch in a restaurant open to the public, if he cannot send his children to the best public school available, if he cannot vote for the public officials who represent him, If, in short, he cannot enjoy the full and free life which all of us want, then who among us would be content to have the color of his skin changed and stand in his place?
Ooh, powerful. How many days did it take to shoot that?
We actually shot it in 3 days. We begged, borrowed, and we did it for just $12,000.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wishing you all the best.
Thank you very much.
So when somebody says law, that's all they need to know.
I hope so. I hope so.
I really did appreciate the time. And thank you so much for bringing an awareness to this.
Appreciate it.
Stay tuned for more on Live It Up. We're celebrating filmmakers and all types of creatives right here.